some of the audience questions. Hello.
Hi. I hope you had a great day so far.
Thank you. Yeah.
Okay. My question is, if you could choose an episode of any show you played a character in, which one would you choose to be your favorite?
Ooh. So many to choose from. I think first season Prison Break when Michael goes to the psych ward. That was a favorite. Fifth season Prison Break, Michael meets his son for the first time. Third season Legends of Tomorrow, Leo Snart kisses his boyfriend.
Thank
you.
Bye.
Suddenly I understood that there was nothing I would not do for these little ones. There was nothing I would not do to protect these little ones. So when it came time for me to play Michael as a father, I understood better that dynamic where there's nothing Michael would not sacrifice to keep his son safe.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, I'm really happy to see you again this year at the convention in Europe.
Thank you,
and I hope there will be more in the future. My question is, if you could choose a moment or an hour of your life to relive, what would that be and why?
Ooh, that's a good question. It's a very good question. I think I'd probably go back and maybe relive booking some of my first acting gigs. When I first started working as an actor, my first job was guest star on Buffy the Vampire Slayer, and I was a struggling actor at the time, working hard to keep a roof over my head, and then the next thing I knew, I was working with Sarah Michelle Gellar and David Boreanaz on a back lot in Hollywood at 3 in the morning doing stunts. And it was surreal and a dream come true. And I don't think at the time I really appreciated it for what it was because I was so nervous and so out of my depth. So it might be nice to go back and relive that experience for starters.
Thank you.
Thank you.
First of all, thank you so much for coming here. I literally cannot believe you're sitting right in front of me, and it's insane, oh my god. Okay, so my question is, what was the funniest thing that's ever happened to you on the set of Prison Break?
The funniest thing?
Yeah.
There weren't a lot of laughs on that show, it was pretty dark. Dominic is, he's a cut-up. He keeps things interesting. I'm trying to remember a specific joke or some bit of funny business. I can't off the top of my head, I'm sorry.
Okay. Thank you anyway.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Sophie. Thank you for being here. I was wondering what the differences are between Michael and you in real life.
Michael and him in real life, is that your question? The
yes.
difference?
Yes.
Between
Michael's a convict, for starters. He's been to prison. He's responsible for a death or two. I'm none of those things, to my knowledge. I think Michael is also fiercely loyal. I could be loyal too, but he's willing to go to certain extremes that I think I would be hesitant to go to, that your average person would be hesitant to go to. He's a fictional character in that regard. And it's one of the distinctions between Michael and myself is that if he is a superhero, you know, know, he's meant to be a real person. He doesn't have superpowers, but his belief in himself, his fanaticism, these are the things that make him extraordinary. And sometimes I don't believe in myself, and I don't have that fanatical kind of quality. So he's an extremist, and I think of myself as being more middle of the road, maybe.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi. What was your reason to become an actor?
I became an actor because acting is an excuse to do and say inappropriate things, and I tend to be a very appropriate person, so it was helpful to find a context in which I could act up and get paid for it.
I like the video.
Thank you.
Hi.
You're the actor, like, not just for acting, but also for what you do to help people with mental health issues. I think it's really important that some people can have an idol to look up to and say, he went through the same thing I did, and maybe that can help them become a little bit stronger for a while. And I wanted to know, you're the ambassador now of Active Minds, and I wanted to know if there are maybe any plans to expand something like this to help people more nationwide.
I think it's a great idea. It's a conversation that needs to be had in more places. More and more people need to, I think, in a way that feels appropriate and safe for them, speak up about what they're going through as far as mental health. I would like to be a part of that conversation in whatever way feels real and possible and safe for me. At the moment, I'm not able to participate as much as I'd like because I've got a lot of stuff going on the personal front, but once those things are settled and taken care of, then my hope is to re-enter into that conversation in some way possible.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So my question is, did you ever steal anything from the set of Prison Break, like a little souvenir or something like that?
That would be appropriate, right?
That would be appropriate. Yeah. I don't think I stole anything from the set of Prison Break. I asked for things and was given things. I never had to steal anything.
Or did you ever take something from another set you acted on?
From a real person that I acted on.
Another set?
No, I don't tend to take things that don't belong to me.
I have a feeling they really want you to steal something.
Yeah.
So.
Thanks, sorry, question wise.
Thank you.
Alright.
Hi.
Hi. What do you like the most about your character, Michael Scofield?
That he's a survivor. I think that's one of the pleasures of watching Michael Scofield is that he suffers, and he suffers, and he suffers, and comes out the other side. Not always in one piece, but he does survive. That way I think he's potentially inspiring. And it's another way in which he is a superhero, is that he is able to survive certain situations that will finish the next person.
Thank you.
Hi again, I hope you had a great time so far here in Germany.
I have, thank you.
And my question is, you recently posted on Instagram that you have finished up your last episodes of DC Legends of Tomorrow and The Flash, and I was wondering, is that really like forever, or would you ever come back for a few episodes of either of these series if the teams asked you to?
I have one more episode to shoot, which I'll do in January, and I think it's going to be an episode of The Flash, and then that is it for me contractually. But I will never say never, because I do enjoy this character so much. I have a lot of affection for the cast, and it's really hard working crew. I enjoy working in Vancouver, so there are many reasons to come back. It just has to be the right, it has to be the right story. So far, I think we've done a really good job of exploring all that Leonard Stark is in his various incarnations. If
So in the TV show you are playing the role as a man who puts a long life story behind him and where also a lot of feelings, emotions, disappointments and also hopes are included within, and I personally get already a big fan of you, Michael Scofield, and also the other characters while I watched it on TV. And my question is, how is it for you? So how do you separate these two personalities between yourself and Michael Scofield? And how difficult is it for you to isolate, especially the role of Scofield, from your daily lifestyle?
Wow. I don't typically have trouble distinguishing between myself and Michael Scofield. I'm helped by the fact that there's a set, there are other actors, there's a script, there's lights, there's cameras. So I know when I'm Michael Scofield, I know when I'm not Michael Scofield. I will take him home with me though, if I'm not careful. It's a dark show, you know, there's a lot going on, it's heavy, people are dying, there's a lot of bloodshed, and even though I know it's not real intellectually, if I play the same scene where I'm being beaten up 30 times in a row, some part of my physical body, because I'm acting like it's true, will believe it's true. So at the end of the day, it's important for me to acknowledge for myself that, all right, that was pretend, I'm safe, that didn't happen, I'm a different person, I'm home now, and I can let that go. That might look like taking a walk around the block, it might look like a hot bath with Epsom salts, or maybe lighting a candle, or a dinner conversation with a friend, or watching a show that's a comedy, so I can laugh. Something to distinguish between, all right, this is my real life, this is who I am, this is what's true, this is what I do over here before living.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hi.
It's really great that you are here. I hope you can see us.
I can.
No, man.
We are great fans.
Awesome costumes.
Thank you. And I'm just here for my friend. So she wants to ask a question, but she's so nervous, so I have to go first and talk with you. And now, Marisa, you have to ask.
Okay, so my question is Prison Break related. And I was wondering, you're an amazing writer as well, and if you ever had a chance to write an episode, would you do it? And do you think the ending of Michael having a happy end is better than the ending of season 4?
To answer your first question, I never had the temptation to write an episode of Prison Break because I trusted Paul Schering and the other writers. They know what's best. They also have a certain sensibility, which is not necessarily mine. The things that I've written before are thrillers, domestic thrillers specifically. So government conspiracies, prison breaks, engineering, these things are not necessarily my go-tos creatively. So I leave that to the powers that be. And I was satisfied with the final ending, the fifth season of Prison Break, Michael and Lincoln in the park with their loved ones. It was a moment of relaxation, joy, calm, peace. Whether any of that can actually continue is another question. I think given everything that Michael and Sarah and Lincoln have been through, they have every right to spend the rest of their lives paranoid and vigilant and worried about threats behind every corner. And if the show does continue, that might be where we pick up. Thank you.
Okay, we have time for two more questions. And then we have to... Is it on? Hi. Yeah.
Just
a little bit closer to the microphone,
oh,
please.
Okay.
Thank you.
I would love to know, where do you find peace in life?
I'm working on finding it within, you know, so I can carry it here with me, wherever I am, no matter what the circumstances might be. This sort of environment is stressful. to a certain degree, it's not my natural habitat. Lights, noise, people, strange place. If I were searching for peace out here, I'm not sure I would find it. So it's important to me to cultivate a sense of inner peace, so no matter where I am, no matter who I'm talking to or what I'm doing, there's something that feels safe and protected in here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, Wentworth. I'm Jessica. I'm deeply grateful to meet you here and creating unforgettable memories. I know you are not fluent in German, that's why I do my best and stick to the English language. I'm nervous. After everything you have achieved in life and have been through, is there something you still miss? Are you finally happy or do you still have a few goals you want to reach? I mean, are you considering writing a screenplay so you can work? Or are you going to concentrate more on your acting? Maybe you like the better?
Could you speak into the microphone because we're moving forward, but the sound keeps staying the same.
One more time, please.
One more time. After everything you have achieved in life and have been through, is there something you still miss? Are you finally happy? Or do you still have a few goals you want to reach?
Okay, so do you have any other goals in your life that you would like to achieve?
I think there are things I haven't fully expressed yet as an actor. I think I'd like to imagine there's some more dramatic roles or comedic roles out there for me to tackle and enjoy. But I don't tend to look at my life through the lens of what don't I have, what has not happened for me yet, who I haven't met. I tend to focus on what I